In this tutorial, we'll run a cell count analysis using the assisted point count with Find Maxima command. Start ImageJ with custom macros installed. Log in by pressing the Start button. Press keyboard shortcut F12 to open the current user folder. Open the results.txt file of the user. To monitor results, it's important to use a text editor that dynamically prompts users upon changes to the open file. We recommend the free and open source programs Notepad++, Geany, Kate, and in this case, Gedit, or Gedit. Drag and drop the first image for analysis onto the ImageJ main window. Press keyboard shortcut F4. The assisted point count prompt appears. Confirm that the user output folder is correct. Since this is a non-fluorescence image with no discernible color separation, let's choose No for signal of interest. Since this image contains dark points on a light background, check the light background box. And I won't save settings just yet. Actually, finally, let me set a little bit of a higher tolerance value. So please note that in recent versions of ImageJ, tolerance has been renamed prominence, but this does not affect the steps of the procedure. So at 60 tolerance of prominence, these are the points that have been selected. So it's easier to add points than to remove them. So setting a slightly higher prominence value is a good idea. And also make sure that the exclude edge maxima value or setting is checked off. Nothing at 70. At 60, you get this point here, which would be outside of our stereological criteria. Let's set it back to 70. And that looks good. So follow the instructions in the prompts and follow along as I remove and add points. So one way to see what's underneath these point markers is to actually select none or select or restore selection by pressing Control Shift A or Control Shift E. But it's also fine to just move these points around. So this is an odd looking object, but I'll count it and will defer to my colleagues later upon review on what to make of this. I'll remove this count because I believe it's too small. And everything else looks good. Now, I'm not adding points at this point, although one can, but I'll do it the traditional way and not add this obvious point. So now the points that I've added have been masked out, so there are no double counts, and now I'm adding points. So this object here is as small as this one, not going to count it. I will count this object, and otherwise I believe that the count is accurate. And you can see a running log of what's been happening here. So that's it. You have your result picture. We have 51 count. Note that the masked out yellow points were ones that were selected by the Find Maxima. This yellow X is the one that I added independently. And we're satisfied here, so press OK. And here's our running results list. Press keyboard shortcut F12 again to open the current user folder. And you can see that a new folder has been generated based on the image name. And check the results file. Note that a results line has been added with a cell count of 51. And let's open the newly generated folder. I will arrange this by type. And let's see what data was generated. So follow along with this description here of the suffixes that are used for the 9, or let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the 7 generated files. So we have 3 images. The format is the file name, the suffix is original, and this is the original unaltered image used for analysis. Let's open that up. So that is there for comparison. Next is the file name with the word count, then the number of points, which is our result, followed by the word final. That's the resulting image after counting, with point markers and result count number in the corner for convenient review. Let's take a look at that. That looks familiar. That's the image that we saw as the final step of our analysis. And the third picture here is the file name with the word count, but it's not final. There is a number of points. And that image has the same point markings as the one with the word final, but with smaller labels for clarity during review. And also, if this were a fluorescent image, let me finally open this up. If this were a fluorescent image, only the color channel analyzed would be shown. So you can see here, instead of the yellow masks, you have these light crosses, and you can see what's going on underneath. And this oblong object here can be discussed afterwards. So two spreadsheets are generated. One called file name. In this case, it would be ID26FB01 10X with the suffix region results. And this spreadsheet has the area measurements for the region in which the counts were performed. Now, you may recall we didn't actually select the region. We just use the entirety of the image. But this data is especially important if users are manually tracing anatomical regions prior to point counts, because it allows for checking the variance of the sampled area between subjects, and that's possibly revealing significant skew. So as an example, let's say you have an experiment where you're comparing a brain region under two experimental conditions, but for some reason the point counts being performed in one of the subjects is in a region that is just much smaller. So there might be a confound of either the anatomy being different or of the user finding something odd about that picture. And the second spreadsheet here is one that actually has the result data. So that's the file name with the word count with the number of points and then results.csv. And this has the measurement data including XY coordinates and intensity values for each point counted. Let's actually open that up. So you may recall we had 51 points, and with the heading, that's 51 points. This is currently being sorted by area, but if we were to sort this by the x-axis, the values begin to seem more plausible in terms of mean. And finally, two regions are created. So the aforementioned region results, which is the selection in which the point counts were made, not only are the measurements for that region saved, but the region itself is saved. In this case, our region.roi is simply a rectangle of the entire image. And the most interesting region is file name count, number of points, roi.zip. And this region actually contains the points that we counted. So let's see how this region here can be used. Load the original.png file, which is identical to this file without the word original. And then load the roi.zip. And you can either highlight or you can use the shortcut 0 to select and deselect region points. So again, upon review, we have a region that we can add or remove points after the fact. So I just closed the remaining windows that we had open. And remember, the entire interactive procedure that we went through and all this data that was generated was simply through pressing a single keyboard shortcut, F4. There were some intervening steps. Nonetheless, the command that facilitated it was keyboard shortcut F4. Now, finally, let's do a quick analysis of the second image. I'll press F4 again. I liked 70 last time, and I will check the settings to save them so this prompt will not show up in the future. And another 51 points. I think 70 works fine. Note that if we were to set this to 40, this inconsequential point would have been selected, which is why it tends to be a good idea to set a higher prominence. So let's stick with 70. Now, even though we excluded the edge points, this fell outside of the algorithm's criteria, but I don't believe that this object is entirely within the bounds of our sampling window, so I will remove it. And everything else looks good in terms of removal. And in terms of adding points, that looks good. So here we have 57. Of course, we can review it later as in the previous procedure. Here we have the log of what was done by the user. Let's open up our results file again. You can see that there's another folder that's been added. And now we have a second result line amended, 57 points. And at this point, one can continue with the entire sample of the experiment. And that's the assisted point count of Find Maxima tutorial.